So batch normalization is a technique designed to standardize the inputs to a layer, the deep neural network. We are standardizing the normalization. Will help the normalization of a data. The layers will transform the input so that they are standardized, meaning that they will have the mean is 0 and standard deviation of 1. During the training, the layers will keep a track of statistics, each input variable, and use them as a standardizing of the data. How this will help? Okay, standardization, you know that mean 0 and standard deviation equal to 1. How this will help to my model? Anybody can answer this? Batch normalization. Naveen, can you answer this?
Sir, batch normalization is a technique, but to standardizing, okay, means exactly we are increasing the stability of a neural networks, right? Okay, mean 0 and standard deviation 1 means that is exactly a standard normal variate.
So how this will help the your machine learning, your learning of process?
I didn't get your points there.
How this normalization will help the learn the data faster? The batch normalization mitigates the effects of the varied layer inputs. Like what will happen? I have a x1 and x2 and x3. I have a 4 features. This might be in a different scales. This might be in a different scales. When you are passing the data to hidden layers, these scales are in a similar.
Yes, we must bring a similar scaling for all variables. Scaling.
By normalization of output of the neurons, the activation function will only receive the inputs close to zero. Right? Inputs close to zero. So there won't be any zero values. This ensures that non-vanishing gradients. This was the point. The batch normalization will help us write on this point. Batch normalization will help us ensure that non-vanishing gradient. We talked about vanishing gradients. Again, we'll talk in the vanishing gradients in the tomorrow class. Benefits of the batch normalization. It prevents the vanishing gradients network with the shutterable non-linearities and regularize the model and allows for higher learning rate. It can able to learn properly. The most important things we do in the batch normalization, dropout, data augmentation. This is what will make your model to perform better. Is there any doubt for this of the today's session? We will go and see the lab exercises. We can see how it will work out, how this overfitting and how this regularization will help, how this dropout will help. We are not going to take any use case. We are going to talk about with individual variable and how it impacts. Any doubts so far of the today's session? I hope. Okay. Any doubts for this session? Sagar, any doubt? Everybody clear? If you are clear, just give type 1. in the chat window.
Just one doubt, this platform migration will help the conversion model very fast, or it is different?
It's obviously, it is like we don't have any negative values, right? The values will be close to zero, and there is a no zero values that where your convergence will struck. There is no concept called local minimum here. You can come across that situation. I believe everybody got understood of this session. I'll move on to the. Improving of a neural nets. I'm gonna how do we improve the neural nets? First we'll talk about overfitting. Okay, we will see how this will help us. We'll try to see whether it is being overfitting or anything. Overfitting or not overfitting. See, basically, I'm taking the data x and y. I'm building a model of the sequential and input dimensions are two input thing, and I have activation is ReLU and output. So I'm trying it for epoch 4000, and I'll be keeping as two. Let us see what is happening on the error rate on the training and test data, training accuracy and test accuracy. You guys need to tell me, what is this, overfitting or underfitting?
So this input dimension is the number of header layers in the model.
Sorry?
Input dimension equal to 2 is there, right? Does it mean number of header layers in the model?
No. What the data in we are passing it here? I have, let us say, we will see the input data.
इट्स ओवर फिटिंग।
हाँ देखो देखो ओवर फिटिंग हो रहा है, लाइक लेट अस कम डाउन राइट, आने दो ना।
हाँ
हाँ देखो इट्स ओवर फिटिंग, आई वांटेडली डूइंग द ओवर फिटिंग एंड हाउ दस रेगुलराइजेशन विल हेल्प अस, वो तो बताना चाहिए ना। वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट बिफोर वी इम्प्लीमेंटेड टू द मॉडल। First, we should have the basic fundamentals. Then only I can build a greater application.
Sir, how do you say it is overfitting?
And what is the basic fundamental of overfitting, Satya?
It's fine in training and fails for the test.
Huh. Training accuracy is 1. My test accuracy is 94. Here my training accuracy is, you could see right, 1, and here is 94. You see. You could see here, there is no improvement in the loss, the same loss. Here accuracy is 1 and here accuracy is 94 only. There is no thing. And here there is no point that if you train for this many types. But
so, sir, early stop you can...
Sorry?
How to know when to do early stopping, sir?
We use early stopping concept, it will take care of it.
Oh.
No, we use the concept called early stopping, it will take care of it. We don't need to do. That option will do. Here, see, the model is improving. See, accuracy is being degraded. Let us run it. Guys, you should have some patience in the practical. Because machine learning is different, deep learning is different. Deep learning required a lot of patience to run your model. Like this, we need to keep on watching.
Are we going to run model with the early stop loss?
Sorry?
See the difference?
Ravi?
Early stop option is there, right? So are we going to rerun the model with the early stop option to see the difference, how it is stopping when...
I have planned, Ravi. Don't worry. I'll show you. Okay? I will show you that also.
Yeah, sure.
Everything cannot be taught in single day, right? Should be gradually should learn.
Sir, will you be sharing the code so that we can try on our end, sir?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, thank you.
अभी चाहिए?
अभी.
You need now or if you want me to share in a via email, I'll share it.
Yes, sir. Any convenient way, sir.
Huh? Like what do you do? Like get guys, leave your email IDs in the chat window. Someone take a lead to collect all the email IDs. Here, share your email IDs so that I will share the material for the respective classes. And someone take Ganesh, you note down all email IDs and send. Give me, I'll.
Yes, yes, yes.
That makes sense. Now we will go. I am running it for 10,000 epochs. So it is, let it run. We will keep this as a and regularization.
Suresh, one doubt I have. So in machine learning, we spend so much data on cleaning part, right? So deep learning, are we not going to spend much time on the cleaning data, like outliers and noise data, stuff like that?
Outlier data. We will do that. We will do the pre-processing also. The pre-processing step remains same for deep learning or machine learning. But compared to machine learning, deep learning will have less pre-processing. That's it. Okay. Guys, be patient. And here, let it run that example. And guys, focus on here. Great example. I am using the regularization, L1 regularization here. What regularization? L1 regularization. Let me see how this will help us. Completing of this. Guys, are you there here? Following?
Yes, sir. L1 will make it sparse, right? Sir?
We will apply L1 and L2. We will see. You will see L1 and L2 effects also. It is taking. I unfortunately given the 4000 epochs. I might have given the 2000 epochs so that it might have completed by this time. Ravi, see here, I have taken the data set of sklearn make moons. Sklearn data set make moons is a package where I have taken the data. I have not done anything. I have taken the data, sample data. These are the basic fundamentals you should understand to be a data deep learning expert. Without knowing this, I don't think so it will be helping you guys. Thank you. here we are using early stopping concept. Early stopping. Let it run, I'll be back. Guys, you guys, please share the email IDs, right? I think how many we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Others, if you don't want, it's fine. Ganesh, it's fine, Ganesh. If they don't want, it's fine. We got a
car. No, okay, no problem. No problem.
Sorry?
Yes, no problem.
If you are need material, you just do it. Otherwise, we don't worry. now you can see Ravi, I'm doing on the same data set of early stopping. We will see. First we will apply the regularization, then we will see the early stopping concept. Let's just get finished.
Okay.
Okay. Is it fine?
Yes, sir. Yes, yes. Suresh, for information only, in Google for a write, if we want to terminate the process, how we can do it?
Why do you want to terminate?
No, no, just for information.
Just click on this button, it will get terminated. Now I'm not going to terminate because I was about to close everything, so I don't want to do.
Yeah, it's almost 3890
approximately.
We are about to do it.
Guys, these sessions are completely for my passion and it's my happiness. That's it. Nothing to give and nothing to take. I'm a passionate teacher and I love teaching of different ways of learnings. That's it. From basics to advanced. We will gonna cover entire thing in terms of deep learning. Either you can compete with anybody who does masters also. You can talk to the PhD guy if you are clear on these topics. How this will works. On a practical note. Four, five, six, seven, eight, and complete it. Done. Okay. So what is my training accuracy and what is my test accuracy? Guys, is it overfitting or not overfitting?
It's overfitting.
Wait a moment, sir. Completely overfitting problem. Overfitting problem. Problems. So, okay. Now we will see the model graphs. Now training is different. And testing also different. Now, MLP overfit regularization before activation. We are adding the regularization before activation, and we can play with around it. And I'm making it as 500 epochs. I don't want to run it more. Let's see. Or you can practice at home, like understand how this will help us. Now you see here test training is good, again test also good, bad. It's also overfitting, right? Is it overfitting or not overfitting? Here my performance not been improved. So what I'll do, I'll have instead of L1 I'll use L2. I think we should be improving. So L2 is improving. See now, it was moved to 81. Again, it comes to 80. Okay. L1 and L2 is not helping out. Let us see which one will help us. The most of the time, which will help or which may not help. And with that was the reason we have different concept called batch normalization. Now let us see how this early stopping will help. Will not gonna. I have the 4000 epochs, but if it is not improving, it will not gonna work out. Now you see this early stopping concept. Sorry, I'm stopping it because I wanted to see the last function here. This will run. There is no improvement on the, see here, you could see there is no improvement in the accuracy, so it should stop ideally. It will stop after a couple of after some epochs. Definitely it will stop. Here you could see there is some improvement. Whenever there is no improvement, then it will stop. You can see batch normalization also. Now you could see it will stop somewhere here because my accuracy on the training is 1 and test is 92 only, right? So it should stop ideally. So see, Ravi, can you see this at 891 early stopping?
Yes, sir. Yes, yes.
This how my early stopping will work. If there is no improvement in this one, I don't need to train it again. Okay, this is what we will see, batch normalization, how it is help us. Batch normalization will solve the problem of now I'm using the batch normalization here. See, batch normalization helped us or not? Ravi? Everyone? batch normalization how the training and test accuracies are same. Guys, in this particular example, the batch normalization, what is my accuracy on a training data set? Guys, are you following?
Huh?
Okay. Any thumb rule for number of epochs are we must find via experimenting with the different values. There is no thumb rule, Meenakshi. Like, we need to use. Yeah, Satyas, I have. Ankit, do you have any plans for tomorrow? Ankit?
Sir, no plans. I was going to brush up my concepts on that.
Okay, tomorrow I have a lined up here. The same concepts with emergency vehicle classification, cat and dog, and with how do we implement the model, how to tune the your parameters. How to make it tuned models. See here, dropout and we wanted to see today how dropout will help us, right? Dropout. Where is dropout concept here? How was the session today? Is it helpful?
Yeah, was it great?
Yes.
Huh? It's great. Great. Today is great.
Can you put it in chat window? So we will post it in like people will say. Not SR and no sir. Huh? Like write some descriptions, boss. So people will join us and we'll learn more effective. Okay, it's not for the any promotional ads. Like, I'm just thinking to what is this? At least stopping. I'm looking for this one. Dropout. Decoupling the layers with the dropouts. We wanted to use the dropout to prevent the overfitting. We will see model with dropout case study, binary classification problem. Okay, great to hear, and I'll be posting this to get the more crowd to make this. All institutes should go for TOS. That is what main intention. Either I'm not against for the institutes, those who are coming up every day, 2,000 rupees, 1,000 rupees data science. No, it can be taught free, but the content what you are giving is matters for us. Right now you see. Thank you, Ankit. And guys, please post it like in LinkedIn also. So what are we are doing here? And we are gonna see how this will work out. This is what happened, right? Now we wanted to see the dropout concept here. We will see how dropouts will help us. drop out concept. Okay. I'm running it for we'll run it for 15,000 epochs. Then we will apply the dropout. Here we are not applying any. Here we are not applying any dropout. We have just taken the values of x and y. I have just created a simple neural network. And here most important point you should remember this model.summary. Model.summary in the dropout area. Model.summary you should remember. I'm running this. This is what without dropout. Verbose will give you. Sir, you should post it in YouTube. No YouTube, Ankit. No YouTube, nothing. If they need it, they will attend. They will reach out to me. They will learn. That's it. No YouTube, nothing. We don't want to be like YouTube is messed up with whatever they will teach. They don't teach what industry is expecting or how to you upskill. It's not about running MNIST or running this. If you don't need these values, this kind of every each and every fact, you cannot become a good like. What is happening here? You cannot become a good computer vision specialist or something. In fact, we are not wasting our time, and also we are not talking about a basic stuff. We are talking with very useful information. There was an issue here that this will come accuracy. I never seen any course in YouTube that with a clear explanation of this dropouts, this regularization parameters with the practical. I have seen n number of videos they will discuss. They have not shown the detailed explanation. Guys, if you have seen it, let me know. That was the reasons that deep learning, why I was promoting here. There is no clear information. They will tell this is what. But they don't have the practical implementation. That was the reason we are doing here. You can see here the accuracy part is not being printed because of this one. So what is this here? Training. This is overfitting or underfitting? Ash.
Overfitting.
What we will do? We will solve. Now you check the note down the model.summary. How many parameters here? We have 2001 parameters. Now we will add the dropout concept, right? We will do the dropout concept. here you can see the dropout 0.4. It meaning of that I'm dropping, it's a dropping of 40% of connections. 40% is of 40% of connections. Here dropping, you can make it like a 0.5 or 0.3, 0.6, whatever. We can we will go with 0.3, and we'll try to understand. We'll try to understand the
Suresh, what is the max dropout rate we can give?
We cannot give zero. We cannot give one, right?
Yeah, there is some threshold, right?
No. Try to understand the concept, Ravi. Like, we cannot give one. If you are giving a one, it is meaning that you are collapsing entire network, right? There is no point of working. It should be like 20%, 10%. We'll start with dropouts with like 10%. We will see 20%. We will see. Wherever it is giving best, we will keep that one. There is no thumb rule. Alright.
Okay.
What I will do here. Send it. We need to work on a different dropouts and see the performance actually. This dropouts will help us the improving your neural network. Now you could see again there is an overfitting, right? Then you can change that dropout parameter and you can train it for more number of epochs. That will help us in terms of your learning. So I hope you can understand this one. You can play around with this. I'll download it as this one as a printable way. I'll put it in the LinkedIn. the same. Am I making sense? Pencil. What I'll do here, I will delete the outputs so that the pages will be less. These graphs, let it be. Here you could see, here whenever we are having the dropout, right, here there is no dropout. Here you have the dropout here, right? When you see that model.summary, you can see the difference. Now dropouts, you can, now you can practice this ones. I will upload this notebook in the your that same post what we have discussed. Okay, I'll post it. Okay, so tomorrow will be vehicle classifications, Cypher 10 dataset to predict the cat or dog or whatever the animals. So we will do some more good stuff, emergency vehicle classification, lot more things to follow. So very high end architectures. And guys, hope you are enjoying the sessions. We'll continue the sessions, and shall we continue the sessions weekly, 5 days in a week? Or 7 days in a week? Suggestions, please. We will see how it goes, and I'll be uploading this thing with here. I'll be uploading the document here for the same notebook. You can download it here. I'll be uploading here. Oh, this is what yesterday's one, right? Which one? Okay. Here I'll be uploading here. or else I'll post new one.